What you call a situation on a North Canol Road. I just discovered with Tim that my toe in adjustment is totally wrecked and my left wheel is totally loose, going any way it wants. So since the tread is totally worn out, we're gonna attempt to do on-site welding. And since Tim had his foresight and intuition, he brought a welding kit. So this is the first time we're gonna weld using the batteries of his Delica. We'll see what happens.
I want to disconnect this from my motor though before we weld.
Oh, good idea.
That way,
okay, so finally we figured it out. Well, Tim figured how to connect all the batteries so he has the biggest amperage possible. Is that correct? Amperage?
Yeah, we're voltage.
Voltage.
We have 12, 24, 48 volts.
Yeah. He's just gonna tuck it in. We measured it, and it's exactly 54 inches at the back, so 54 in the front. And off he goes. Out. Okay.
I gotta get a better connection here.
Well, it's all covered with paint, eh? And grease.
Oh, there we go.
Well, it's tacked. Check that out. Melted right through it.
Nice.
It's not beautiful. I was actually closing my eyes because it was too bright.
Wow.
Yeah, so the lenses in this thing are not good. But better than nothing. At least I can start.
I'm just kind of going blind.
I got an attack up top.
Okay, it's too hot actually.
Yeah.
I have the big tarp, and we can put a string between two trees and then set up the huge canopy, like a huge tent,
okay,
underneath.
Or we could just put park close together and then have the tarp between the vehicles.
Yeah, either.
Because that way, that's the cooking area in between. Kind of like what we did before, but we didn't need a tarp.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, Tim, what's for dinner?
Rice, sausage.
Ah, the usual.
Green drink. Unusual. We already had that.
Why is your diesel running?
Charge my rice cooker. It's steaming away there.
Expensive dinner.
Well, it doesn't have to be that running. It's like a diesel generator if you had a motorhome. Look at that, cooking away. Oh boy.
Thank you.
Mackenzie Mountains and on the Canol Road, day 4, and there's Mount Itzy in the far distance with the glaciers. Dominic's probably painting that right now down below, and I decided to run up this peak because it was such a nice day with such excellent weather, and get a panorama view of where we are. Okay, well, I decided to hike up to the next bigger one. The one that I was on before is quite a bit below us. And here you're looking straight down the North Canol towards the Northwest Territories on my right here, somewhere down there. And the Canol Road goes right down there. Here's the little summit cairn. And there's quite a peak down here over my shoulder. I'm not sure what that's called, but it's quite glaciated. And it looks bigger than Mount Itzy, which is coming up shortly. So we're looking down the Canol Valley. That's what it's called. And there's Mount Itzy right here over my shoulder. Looks like a lot more cloud cover's coming in. So it makes for some great shadows. I'm sure Dominic's getting some awesome paintings down below. And down there is one of the summits that I had done earlier on the previous video. But it's quite a ways below me. I'd say probably 500 feet or more, maybe 700 feet below. This is one of the bigger lumps of shale, I guess. That gives you a pretty good view of what's going on here.
Well, it's a lot faster going down than up, that's for sure. Woo-hoo.
It's the second day on Canol Road. We made it to an old mining road, exploration road. Tim is somewhere all the way at the top of this mountain. He took his car over there. Maybe we can see it if I zoom in. Now there he is. And he's hiking. I decided to paint. Sir's painting on Canol Road, view of Mount Itzy.
Hey, how's it coming there?
Up pretty good. Second day on the Canol Road.
No, this is the fourth.
Oh, fourth. Well, second day of painting.
Oh, yeah.
Spectacular view of the Mount Itzy there.
Yeah, we'll have to take a look.
It's pretty clear right now. First snow on the peaks.
Oh, yeah. You're gonna get a good view of your painting here and the peak. Very cool. Here, I'll back up so you can see it. And then the dog is the critic. Oh, wait a minute, he's not looking. All right.
He's ignoring
us.
The creative process.
Okay, well, this is a great vista you have here. I'll just pan around. There's some Dominik trees. There's my van. Yeah, wow. Oh, and that's the peak I was on top of. Dominik's got video of me up there. I hiked down just now, and he was doing work. I was playing. There we go. We'll just zoom in on the painting here.
I can't play. I don't have enough fuel to play.
Oh, that's true. Wow, that's nice. Very nice.
Well, this is McMillan River. Well, here we are on top of the big mountain. Came from way down there. You can see the little camp down there. And we're going all the way up to this pass. You can see all the roads going all over the place. So what do you figure? You like this? That's all you got to say? To all your fans out there?
Dominik just said, we'll try this just for the painting's sake. He's made a lot of money across this river, up in the hills. So Tim's behind him with a winch, just in case he's attached, in case the tube starts floating away. We were here 3 years ago, but the water's up quite a bit higher, I think.
Thank you. I'll have to winch you.
Bit of a drop.
Well, turn it as you're going backwards.
Wow. Dove right down, eh? Thank you.
a chance to zoom out on that. Do you want to go back and do that again?
System or non-existing.
Everything was sketchy, even the outhouse.
Even the outhouse.
Anyway, it was nasty weather, so it was a good place to hang out. Thanks to the people that left it behind open for us. Yeah, we did a few repairs and leaving it better than we found it, so that's all I think we could ask, I suppose. We're grateful.
We're on a quest to find a new cabin.
Yeah, now we're off to find a new cabin. Who knows? Maybe we can find one. So Dominik's going into his tent here. I lent him the tent so that he doesn't have to sleep under the Jeep. He can sleep on top of the Jeep. Isn't that right, doggy? Hey, Heidi. Oh, yeah.
No more. I don't know what's wrong with the thermos under the Jeep and the tarp, you know? I don't know.
The bears like you better down there, that's for sure.
Yeah, the bears like it and the girlfriends don't.
That's true. Yeah. Yeah, the women forcing you to upgrade.
Thank you.
we are just about to cross another river. Here in the foreground, you see a bonded bridge from the 1940s, which collapsed over the years.
Northwest Territories, top of the world up here. Pretty amazing looking. We're having a bout of good weather for once after being here for a couple weeks. And I'm just panning around so you can see some of the landscape around off to my shoulder there.
Just coming out of that valley, this way, this side of it.
One of many mud holes. We are past the North Canol Road. Right here, you see a hole. Hopefully it's not too deep. Thank you.
Dominik's truck made it here. Well, oh, no, this is his truck here.
His truck made it.
Ooh, old Muddy. Yeah, Muddy made it in. And the dog made it. Yeah. You're getting bounced around out there.
So inline six.
Yep. Well, it's not a flathead six, so that's interesting.
These are like a really big station,
right? Yeah, looks like it. I think I might need some rubber boots to get in there. Looks like the wardens use this place to staple their horses still. Looks like this was the old diesel generating station. And they got all the pads left here for the diesel generators. All the ducting up here. And holes in the roof. Amazing, still hanging in there after about 60 years.
Oh, concrete floor. Look at all the old bed, eh?
Yeah. Looks like this is a shower house. I bet. Hey, looks like this is the hanging shed for the hunters.
Yeah, just outside we see about five caribou hoofs. So they've been killed in the last few days.
Yeah, and then they hang them here, and I guess what they do, they quarter them or whatever?
Yeah, just the butcher and they let them here, there is a rack. They let them here, and once they are done, they just cut them off. So this stays behind.
Yeah, I wonder how much a caribou weighs. Looks like Dominik found the wood stove.
Solid.
Solid. And this obviously is the burn pile. Old style Quonset huts. Not with the metal roofs, it looks like. The looks like it's all bent wood.
So Tim, what do you say? Where are we?
Oh, it looks like some kind of remnant camp from World War II. And these look like the Quonset huts for the lodging, the, I guess the workers. Yeah, maybe the maintenance crew too.
Yeah.
It's look like quite a few people here. Anyway, from what, about in the 1940s, I think?
1943.
Wonderful colors. Well, it looks like the road kind of disappears here. We have to skitter our way through that.
So Tim, where are we?
Nowhere. We're in Northwest Territories, but close to the Arctic Circle, in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, we are in about 50 kilometers just past the border, and the road, North Canol Road, it looks like it hasn't been traveled at this part, so we are taking our time. Beautiful foothills here, just gorgeous tonality of colors.
Wonderful colors. Thank you.
So we are on the Canol Road here, a little side road repair. Tim broke his, what is it?
Handheld rod.
That's right. He has already had a stress point from the previous bend, as you can see. It's totally broken. And Tim gonna do the cross
straps
to keep the axle in the line of the symmetry of the body. The Russian style. Dog is not helping.
I don't know, I think this is Polish.
Polish?
Yeah. Yeah, I got lots of pipe on it.
Awesome.
So I thought I could put the Panhard rod right inside of this pipe and then weld around on the ends. I mean, I could just grind it off right now, but...
No, I mean, it doesn't take any...
I couldn't get through all this stuff in front here. And, I'm just going slow anyway. So that's the pass there, I guess.
I guess so.
Right there. I mean, we can camp anywhere, though.
Well, let's get to the cabin.
Well, they said the cabin was down below, but who knows how far that is.
Here we are in Caribou Pass, and took us all day to get here from the Northwest Territories border and the Yukon border. And the sun is just setting, and we've just got here to the, well, there's a new hut and then the old traditional hut sitting here. So we have seen lots of mud. And I broke a car part, which tomorrow I'll have to weld back on using our batteries. We'll have a video of that. Maybe we'll go take a look in the inside of these cabins. Give you an idea what they look like. And that down there, past Dominik, is the outhouse. No walls, just a seat. Old Squaw Lodge, it's called. And this puppy is kinda amazing. Oh, thank you. Yeah, if I back up, it's got everything. Stoves, cups, some chairs, and a little airtight. I guess this is what the trappers used to use. Nice and low, not too much space to have to heat. Ooh, look at that, there's even propane. So, we're gonna stay here for the night, I guess. Goes. See if this technique works.
This one worked.
Okay. The dog doesn't even drink that water. But that stuff is toxic, maybe. Lovely. Look at that. All right, well, I'm going to sign off while I still have some battery left. And that was the chicken rendering. The next thing is cooking it up.
Any flour?
We have flour. Well, we have pancake mix, so that would do.
And we have flour, too.
Oh, you have flour. Okay. All right. Well, that'll be the next video. So, this is the second weld job. The first one was on Dominik's, as we've seen, and now it's my vehicle. So I'm gonna get ready to zap it right now.
Or maybe you can show the battery lineup. Oh, what it took, what it actually takes to weld it.
So
as you can see, we are in the middle of nowhere, about 350 kilometers from the nearest civilized outpost.
Yeah, we're a long ways. We're about, how long do you figure?
At least 350.
Yeah, 350 kilometers from anywhere. This little cabin here is a long ways out, and we're amazed it's here, but we're happy it's here. We had a good night out there last night, even though it was way below zero. But it's nice today. So, what we're doing here is this mess here, octopus mess of batteries, combination of Dominik's batteries and my batteries, creates around 50 volts of DC electricity, which is just enough to spark up a welding rod so we can tack and hopefully weld all this back together. I'm not a welder. It might look ugly, but I'm sure it'll hold because Dominik's held and we've gone a long way since that welding. All right, so I'm going to sign off and you can see me weld in a few minutes. Watch your eyes. There we go. Shit. I think I burnt a hole through it.
So Tim just attached the longer pipe, which will hold hopefully everything together.
Yeah, hopefully. So the welds are not great, but hopefully it'll hold. And hey, that's battery bush welding.
Okay, so let's see that job.
No, don't look at the welds, they're nasty. That's some ugly looking stuff.
Woo!
Yeah, you can see the big pipe it burnt through all over the place.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, anyway.
Well,
it'll do.
Yep.
We hope. We'll find out. We'll be right back.
winch face.
If you can smell your own, you know you stink.
They sure had a lot of helicopters and shit, eh? Thank you.